This is your CBS 46 News Update, brought to you by West Shore Home.
Good morning, I'm Gurvy Ardenza. With a recent spike in confirmed coronavirus cases, the city of Atlanta is now requiring face masks in public. Atlanta's Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms signing that executive order last night. Mayor Bottoms had been reluctant to mandate face coverings because of the governor's order, which prohibits local governments from being more restrictive than the state. But the mayor says when she realized the governor was not punishing the mayors of Savannah, East Point, and other cities for enacting mask mandates, she decided to go for it. Mayor Bottoms' order does rather have some exceptions. For most people, though, if you're going into an establishment, you've got to wear a face covering over your mouth and nose. The order getting mixed reaction.
I have my mask in my pocket right here, but I don't wear it all the time because, I'm 22. I don't think it's cool to wear a mask.
All of the experts that I'm hearing from are saying that to help slow the spread, we need to mandate masks, and that's what we're going to do in Atlanta, and hopefully it will help some.
And as I just mentioned, Atlanta's not the only Georgia city that's implementing this critical safety measure. There are five other cities in Georgia all requiring masks, and that includes Savannah, Athens, East Point, and Doraville. Savannah was the first city to implement the safety measure. So here's a look at the latest coronavirus numbers in our state. We had 3,420 new cases in Georgia just in the past 24 hours. Georgia now has nearly 104,000 confirmed COVID-19 cases, and more than 2,900 people have died from the virus. CBS 46 is leading coverage on the coronavirus crisis as cases spike in Georgia. You can download the CBS 46 streaming app to get breaking updates on the pandemic, and those are sent directly to your phone. The app is free in the Apple App Store and also on Google Play. In southeast Atlanta, a shooting has left three people injured, including a 9-year-old boy. The shooting happened on Flat Shoals Road and Glenwood Avenue. The child was shot in the legs several times. We're told he's in stable condition this morning. Two other men were also shot. They were taken to Grady to be treated. They're also in stable condition. Police say an argument between two large groups of people led to the shooting. Right now, we don't have word of suspects being in custody. Media mogul Tyler Perry is stepping up to help a grieving family. The actor and filmmaker is offering to pay the funeral expenses for 8-year-old Sequoria Turner, the young girl shot and killed in Atlanta over the July 4th holiday weekend. Perry told People magazine that he is outraged, saying he'd rather be paying for the Turner's college tuition. Meantime, dozens of mourners gathered, sending more prayers up for peace and justice. A vigil hosted by Hosea Helps was held in the little girl's honor at Atlanta City Hall. Together, the group prayed for Turner's family while addressing the growing issue of gun violence. And there's a $20,000 reward being offered to help police find the person responsible for the shooting. Officers are looking for this man, or for a man rather, in connection with this case. They're calling him a person of interest. It's been steamy for the last several days. We've had a chance of storms. Some areas getting them, some areas not. And kind of the same old story again today. Let's check in on our weather with meteorologist Fred Campagna.
More hit and miss in the forecast for today. Gurvier, check it out. Temperatures will be in the mid and upper 80s, but it'll feel like the low 90s at times this afternoon because of the humidity and isolated to scattered storm threat for all of North Georgia for this afternoon, with any action quieting down this evening. Tomorrow, not much different. A lower risk of some scattered storms in the afternoon, just about a 30% chance on Friday, and the odds of rain diminish some for us over the weekend as the temperature goes up. 92 Saturday, 93 on Sunday. But it'll feel more like triple digits, right around 100, because of the humidity.
This has been your personal news update from CBS 46 News, brought to you by West Shore Home, Atlanta's one-day bath remodeler.